Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to start with accounting revision. This is our topic today. Let's start. Accounting ratio, this is a tool of financial analysis, as we all know. This is the third chapter of the syllabus. Comparative and common size was also a tool of financial analysis. But we really need to understand that before we start with the chapter, we need to know that why are we doing the chapter. This is very, very important. So, as I have already said, that this is a tool of financial analysis. That means by applying ratios, what we do is that we try and understand the financial progress of a business, we try and understand the financial growth of a business. But how do we do it? That's very important to understand. Let us understand the concept today first. Well, ratio, as it says, it is a relationship between two numbers in the financial statements. Two numbers are what? Financial statements. So under financial statements, we have got two things: statement of profit and loss and balance sheet. We all know this. I suppose that you people have already done this in class 11, both statement of P&L and balance sheet. In class 11, it was regarded as accounts, profit and loss account and balance sheet. But in class 12, we have already done statement of P&L, that is under comparative and common size statement. So, relationship between two numbers of the financial statements to analyze the financial health of the business. What is it? To analyze the financial health of the business. Why do we have to analyze? We need to analyze this so that the owner of the business, the board of directors, can take some fruitful decisions about the business. That's why we need to analyze it. So to analyze it, what do we do under ratio analysis or accounting ratio? We try and create relationships between two numbers. Two numbers from where? From financial statements. When I say financial statements, it is either a statement of profit and loss or a balance sheet. That's what we do under financial statements. Now, ratios may be expressed in the following four ways. There are four ways of expressing ratios. I'll quickly read it out for you people. First one is pure ratio, that is dividing one number with another. Very simple, 3 is to 2, 2 is to 1, 1.5 is to 1. You have to just express this in terms of ratio. Number two, it is times. Calculate how many times one figure is that of another. It's very important. That is how you calculate one figure against another and you express that in times. So when that particular part of the formula comes, I'm going to explain you. The third one is expression in percentage. We know this, how to express this. And finally, fractions. That is expression in decimals. 0.10, 0.20. That's what we do under expression under fractions. So let me repeat this once again. I think this will be easier for you. So what we understand from ratio? So it is a relationship between two numbers of the financial statements to derive or to understand financial progress of the business, so that the decision makers of the business, who are the decision makers? The board of directors, the owner of the business, the managers of the business. So these are the people who will look into the financial statement, understand the ratios that has, understand the relationship between the ratios that was created, try and analyze the performance of the business so that some meaningful decisions can be taken. That's why we use ratios under accounting ratio. Now well, ratios have been broadly classified into four categories as per our syllabus. Under classification of ratios, the first one, as we understand, liquidity ratio. Number two, solvency ratio. Number three, activity or turnover ratio. And finally, profitability ratio. So under liquidity ratio, it is subdivided into two parts. These are the main formulas we are going to use under liquidity ratio. Current ratio, liquidity ratio. Solvency ratio, we will use four formulas. Debt equity ratio, total assets to debt ratio, proprietary ratio, and interest coverage ratio. These are the four formulas under solvency ratio. Thereafter, activity or turnover ratios. Under these four ratios, trade receivables ratio, trade payables ratio, working capital ratio, inventory turnover ratio. Finally, profitability ratio, gross profit ratio, net profit ratio, operating profit ratio, and return on investments. So these are the formulas that we are going to learn under this chapter of accounting ratio. So this is what was the small introduction to this chapter of accounting ratio. In my next video, I am going to show you how to derive the how to calculate the formulas, and we will be doing a few sums. we will start with liquidity ratio first. Once we're done with liquidity ratio, that is current and liquidity ratio, then we will move into the next one, which is solvency ratio, and hence on. Thank you.